get some fuel on the bike. To fill up, man, this might be about $4.25, you know? Oh, $4.79. Gosh, I don't know how you can afford it. You're gonna cruise, dude. Miles. Now, I know you guys know that the DRZs are carbureted, they're not fuel injected, and just watch how long you have to choke this thing. Oh my gosh, did you guys see that? Like, I had to choke that for damn near an hour to get it to start. Pretty crappy, unreliable piece of dinosaur turds. Let's just turn in front of the guy on the motorcycle. It's cool. They're from Alabama. Everybody's related there. Just kidding. Just kidding, Alabama. Anybody that watches from Alabama, I was totally just teasing. I'm from Kentucky. Like, you can imagine the jokes. Like, oh, dude, the Kentucky jokes have to be the worst. This is gonna take like forever. I normally don't do that, but just cruise around and bullshit for a little bit, so. But yeah, an honest conversation about this DRZ 400 Supermoto. I love it. You know, obviously I'm a little bit partial to the DRZ because I own one, but I love supermotos in general. I mean, KTMs, Hondas, the KLX 300, the WR250, the Husqvarna 701. I mean, there's so many really good ones out there, and I believe they all kind of serve a little bit different of a purpose. You know, like the Husqvarna being the ultimate big bore 701cc supermoto that's a torque monster, just, you know, an absolute beast, where the DRZ is a lot more tame, but, you know, quite a bit more top end than the WR or like a 300L, or even the KLX 300. Is it a little antiquated? Sure. Is it fuel injected? Nope. Does it have six speeds? Nope. You know, that's just part of its quirkiness that comes along with the bike. But is it stone dead reliable? Absolutely. Does that change? You know, does no fuel injection and a sixth gear change the fun factor of this bike? Absolutely not for me. You know, would a sixth gear be appreciated? 100%, dude. I would love it if this bike had a sixth gear. The fuel injection, like, it fires up quick for me. It's not like constant maintenance like everyone thinks. You know, as long as you're keeping fresh fuel in that thing and not letting it sit stale and gum up your jets, think about how long bikes have been rolling with carburetors, man. Forever. I mean, you know, I have a Honda Z50 that's from, I don't know, the early 80s. It's like an 82, maybe. Carbureted. Fire up on the first kick. It'd be sitting for a year. You know, go out there and kick it three times. Boom. She's running. Like, there's nothing wrong with a carbureted motorcycle. Don't let anyone tell you, you know, make you think less of your particular scooter if it's got a carburetor and it's not fuel injected. Like, whatever, that's cool. Would fuel injection be cool? Yeah, I mean, let's be realistic. But it's also a lot more shit that can go wrong. Like, when you have fuel injection, you have to have a fuel map, right? You have to have computer stuff. You have to have injectors, you have to have, there's a lot more electrical components that could go wrong, whereas a carburetor is pretty much, is purely mechanical. You know, you have an input cable that lifts up your needle, and there's a butterfly valve in there that opens and closes, and a float, but it's all mechanical. None of it's done electronically, so. For me, no big deal. For you, whatever you guys like. I know it's 100% personal preference, but do not let that scare you away. Any form you get on for the DRZ, you're just going to read for days and days and days about how reliable they are. You know, religious oil changes, guys and girls. And you don't even have to do that if you don't want to. Like, you know, you could probably run this thing for 10,000 miles without putting old fucking oil in it, and it would be just fine. Am I going to do that? Fuck no. You can do whatever you want. But yeah, I mean, these things are, they're pretty darn reliable. So, check in the box for reliability. Fun factor. Oh, you can't even, on a scale of 1 to 10, it's like a 27.7. I mean, it's, you can ride it upstairs, downstairs, in the grass, in the woods, wherever you want. Like, you could take this thing off-road, you could, little back road twisties is where I personally believe it likes to live. Like, if you're doing a lot of highway commuting at, you know, 70, 80 miles an hour, like, I would not recommend this. If you're doing a lot of commuting, you know, inner city commuting, if you will, as well as like what I'm doing right now, just some back road blitzing, it's so phenomenal, man. It's badass. It's got decent brakes on it for being 20 years old, huge front rotor, decent size rear rotor. It's not twin rotors up front, but it's got a single, but it brakes really well. Could really tell the difference when I put these Core Moto stainless brake lines on. Yeah, I mean, so fun, man, so fun. And if you're just getting into motorcycles and you're intimidated by a crotch rocket, or you want a supermoto but you want a 701cc Husqvarna, like, this is a great option, along with the KLX 300 and the CRF 300L and the WR, like we talked about. Like, there's so many, the TW 200 even. I mean, that's a little bit different purpose of a bike, but there's so many great little beginner bikes, including this one right here. Relatively inexpensive, extremely low maintenance cost. Literally, you could buy one off the showroom floor for probably around $7,500, brand spanking new, 2022 or 2023, at least in Kentucky, $7,500, and do absolutely nothing to it. Nothing. No jet kit, no exhaust, no mirrors, no airbox mod, no pegs, no grips, no, not a damn thing. You put a headlight in it so your safety improves a little bit at night, and just ride the absolute shit out of that thing for years. And there would be absolutely nothing wrong with that. Like, you could do that for literally years. And the maintenance cost on that would be an oil and a filter at 600 miles, at 4,000. And then they don't even recommend changing the oil filter, I don't think. I think it's just the actual oil after the second one. At like every 4,000 miles, I think, after that, or something close. So, you know, $12 an oil change, like, and you're getting 60 miles a gallon, you know, so riding it pretty hard. So it's like, it's a huge money saver. Insurance is inexpensive for a year. You could, you know, pay it all at one time. But, you know, go and blast through some twisties, man. Get yourself familiar with motorcycling and understand what it's all about. Really open your eyes to see how shitty that, like, drivers on the road are, because, man, nobody looks for motorcyclists. They just pull out in front of you, and it'll give you a whole new respect for looking way ahead in the distance. Chad, if you are thinking about getting a DRZ 400 Supermoto as your first bike, I encourage it, man. Be safe, respect it, because it will fucking jack you up if you don't. Like, you could do a little clutch dump in this thing and flip it straight over backwards. Really, really, really quick. Or, you know, blast through. do a turn way too fast above your skill level and really get yourself fucking jacked up. But yeah, you want to learn, you want to, you know, get your feet wet. It's a great platform to do it on. To do to this bike that I haven't done to it yet. What's funny, my dad keeps asking me, like, how much more shit can you actually put on that thing, son? Lots. There's lots more shit we can do that's really cool. But I want to do a G2 ergonomics quick turn throttle, because you have to really, like, really get your wrist down in an awkward position to open it up to wide open throttle, and I'm not a huge fan of that. Like, you have to almost reposition your hand forward in order to get the purchase on the grip to let it rip. But yeah, here I'm actually gonna take a towel out of my backpack, and my helmet is already, like, just covered in bugs. So oh yeah, man, spit shine work like a charm, dude. Yeah man, I hate that I'm gonna have to choke this thing for like 20 minutes. Oh, it's weird. Because it's warmed up, loser. It's already warm, so you don't have to choke it. Yeah, well. yeah, dude. Check that out. That's what it's all about right there. Beautiful, man. Insta360, if you're watching, dude, yeah, right. Never in a gazillion years. Happened to me. behind you, man. I got rear-ended like at this light before. You know, I had a still have it, a Volkswagen Jetta, and some dude just rolled up behind me, man, just boom, he blasted me. So like, I get hella paranoid about people pulling up behind you, like not paying attention, just being dicks and just smashing into you. It happened to a friend of mine on his Harley, like, I don't know, a couple months ago. Dude was parked at the bottom of a stoplight. Some car just kept going and just blasted him. Shout out to you, Mark. But his Harley's all fucked up. He hasn't been able to ride since. Well, that part blows. But he's okay. And we've already ridden 30 miles. The camera's probably dead anyway. It's probably just talking shit to myself this whole time. But that's fine too. I don't. I'm cool with that. Inmates, whatever are you doing? It's funny, like, I just rode past the jail and it just smells like weed. It's probably that fucked up Mitsubishi Mirage in front of me with the wrong color hood and the headlight out. That's not suspect at all. Actually, I don't really know if it's a Mitsubishi Mirage. Maybe I was being stereotypical with that one. Probably a Kia Rio. It's literally like a light cannon. It's like engage solar rays. Turn on the power of the sun into a beam with a switch on a motorcycle. Which is pretty cool. Like, visibility is just like, probably blind now, but you're gonna have to forgive me, okay? Get out there and ride, everybody. Like, that's what I'll encourage you to do, is just get out and do something. If you're not riding, like, work on your motorcycle, work on your car, your truck, like, do something that drives you to just do what you love. If it's fucking drawing cartoons, like, go do it, man. Draw the shit out of Mickey Mouse. Perfectly cool to do. Adventure, man. Get lost. See something. Go a place you've never been. Do something. It doesn't cost a lot of money to do it. Just get out there and get after it, man. Make a YouTube video if you want to, man. It's not that hard. Get out of your comfort zone. Get after it. You can literally make YouTube videos and put them on the internet with your cell phone. And everybody's got one of those these days. Like, everybody. I know not literally everyone has them, but I would say probably 99% of people that watch, I don't know, man, that would be a neat statistic, like, in your analytics. Like, what percentage of people watch YouTube on their cellular, on their mobile device? I bet it's fucking 99%. I bet 1% is computer or something, like, dude. There's no way there's probably more than 5% that's actually on a computer. I bet it's 95% cellular.
the good guys.
So we just rode 36 miles. Like, we had all that fun for about $2. Like, that's got to be the funnest $2 you can have. Or the most fun you can have with $2.